हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल। वी आर हेयर वंस अगेन फॉर अ न्यू सेशन ऑफ कंप्यूटर एंड दिस इज द पार्ट टू ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 8 स्ट्रिंग। ओके, सो इन दिस सेगमेंट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द स्ट्रिंग मैनिपुलेशंस व्हिच आर परफॉर्म्ड विद द हेल्प ऑफ सम इनबिल्ट स्ट्रिंग फंक्शन। ओके चिल्ड्रेन, so the first string function is a length function। okay, so this function is used to return the length of a string। okay, length of a string, it means number of characters present in the string। for example, given that string str is equal to computer। okay, so length function is used to return or count the number of character present in the string। okay, so in computer we count the number of characters, so here the number of character is 8। number of character is 8। okay, so length function is used to return the length of a string। okay, next one is caret function। This is the most important function, caret functions। okay, so this functions return a character from the given index of the string। okay, so this functions return a character, for example, given that string s is equal to computer and question is character c is equal to s dot caret 3, look at this index value, so index value is 3। okay, so here c is equal to p, because as the character, okay, p as the character at third index is p। okay, look at this, c o m p u t e or r, okay, 0 1 2 3, these are the index values, okay, 0 1 2 and 3, so look at this character। okay, so at the third index value, okay, p character is available। okay, so the final result is p, so it means caret functions return a character from the given index or position number of the string। okay, next one is index of functions, so index of functions, so this functions return the index of a character। okay, index, it means position number, okay, of a character available in the string। for example, string st is equal to understanding, the question is string p is equal to st dot index of n। okay, so index of n means understanding। okay, firstly we write the index value। okay, index value, it means 0 and 1 2 3 4 and 5 6 7 or 8, so here the first position of n in the string is 1। okay, is 1, so by default it return the occurrence of the first position of character available in the string। so index of functions basically return the index of a character available in the string। okay, next, last index of functions, so last index of functions, so this function is applied to find the index of last occurrence of a character in a string। okay, last, so the basic difference between index of and last index of functions, so index of functions, okay, to find the index of first occurrence of a character in a string, and last index of functions is applied to find the index of last occurrence of a character in a string। for example, can this here, given that string s is equal to Malayalam and int n is equal to s dot last index of a, so here it's written 7 to the integer variable n। okay, because the index value or last occurrence of this character means A is a 7. Okay? Mal Alam. MALAYALAM. Okay? Count that 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. This is the last occurrence of this character. Okay? So the result is 7. So last index of function, to find the index of last occurrence of character in a string. Okay? Next one is substring functions. So this function is used to extract a part of a string. Okay? Let me look at this example. So in this example, string s is equal to computer, and the question is string p is equal to s dot substring 3. Substring 3. This is the begin index. This is the begin index or a index value. It is also known as begin index. Okay? So the function will return the character of a string starting from third index. Okay, starting from third index. It means string s is equal to computer. Okay, now we write the index values 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, 3 means the function will return the character of a string from third index value. Okay, from third index value. Okay, so the final answer is PUTER. Okay, in another example, so here string p is equal to s dot substring 3, 6. So here 3 is the begin index and 6 is the last index value. Okay, so it's written a part of a string from third position to the sixth position, but excluding the character which is available at the sixth position. Okay, sixth position character is excluded. Okay, for example, suppose that computer, this is the string. Okay, and question is given that string p is equal to s dot substring 3, 6. 3, 6 means 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, start from this index and 3, 4, and 5, and 6. Okay, and sixth position excluding the character. Okay, means we take the value from 3 to 5. 3 to 5. Okay, so means output is PUT. PUT. The final result is PUT. Okay. Next one is two lowercase functions. Two lowercase functions, this function return the letter of string in lowercase. Okay? Or it's convert the uppercase character into a lowercase. Okay? Next, two uppercase. So this function convert the lowercase character into a uppercase. Two lowercase function convert uppercase character uppercase character into a lowercase. Okay, and two uppercase function, it's convert lowercase into a uppercase simply. Okay, now the replace function. So this function is used to replace a character or a string, okay, by another string or a character. Okay, for example, given that in this string, string l is equal to mx, lx, yx, lx, m. Okay, and the question is string p is equal to s dot replace function x, comma a. So here, each character of x replace with the character a. Okay, hence the new string p will be Malayalam. Okay, here each character of x replace with the character a. So replace function is used to replace a character or a string by another string. Okay, now next function is concat functions. So concat function, this is used to combine two or more than two string. Okay, suppose that string s is equal to computer and y is equal to application. The question is z is equal to x dot concat y. So here The output is computer application. Okay, because concat function is used to concat or join two or more than two string. Okay, next one is equal functions. As the name suggests, equal function is used to compare two or more than two string. Whether they are identical, then output is true, otherwise false. Okay, so in this example, given that string x is equal to computer and y is equal to science, the question is boolean z is equal to x equal y. So here the result is false because computer and science, they are not identical. Okay. Next one is compare to function. Okay, it is the important function. Okay, so it functions also compare the two string, but it not only check the equality of the string. Okay, it's also check whether the string is bigger or smaller than other. Okay, so there are three conditions for compare to function. Okay, first condition is if string x, means string first, is greater than string second. Okay, if s1 is greater than s2, okay, it means n is greater than 0. N is greater than 0. This is the first condition, if s1 is greater than s2. Second condition is if s1 is less than s2, it means n is less than 0. The value of n is less than 0. Okay, and third condition is if s1 equal to s2, it means n is equal to 0. Okay, so in this question, given that string x is equal to computer and y is equal to science, and the question is int n is equal to x dot compare to y, so this function compare to perform comparison based on lexicographical comparison. Lexicographical means like searching a word in a dictionary. Okay, so it result in the difference of the ASCII code of the corresponding characters. Okay, so in string x, first character is C, and for string y, first character is S. Okay, now we take the difference between C or S, so the difference is 16. Differences, the ASCII code difference is 16. Okay, and also check that, so string s1 is less than string s2. Okay, so here string s1 is less than string s2. Okay, it means n is less than 0. Less than 0 means negative value. N is less than 0, it means we take a negative value. So the final answer is minus 16. Okay, clear? So there are three conditions for compare two functions. Okay, n is equal to 0 if x and y, x means first string, y means second string, both are string are same. N is greater than 0 means positive value. Okay, if x means string first is greater than string y means second, and n is less than 0, it means give the negative value if string x is less than string y. Okay, here string x is the first string and y is the second string. Okay, now the next function is trim functions. The trim function is used to remove the leading and trailing. Leading means start, starting, begin, or trailing means last. Okay, leading and trailing blanks from the string. Other blanks which are available in between the words will remain unchanged. Okay, look at this example. So in this example here, look at this leading and trailing space. Okay, when we use trim functions, okay, then output will be computer. So in this snip soon above, string s contain computer with leading and trailing blanks. After using the trim functions, string x blanks are truncated. Okay, hence the resulting string returned in p will be without any leading and trailing blanks. So overall means a string function, sorry, trim function is used to remove the leading and trailing blank from the string. Okay. Yes. Now the next one is end with functions. So this function is used to check whether the given string has a specified suffix or not. Okay. Suffix means, look at this example. A string p is equal to computer is fun and string b is equal to fun. This is the suffix. Okay. This is the second string is suffix. Or here the question is boolean p is equal to end with p. End with b means b is the suffix. Okay. So now it will return x as a true because the suffix is fun. Suffix is fun in this string. Okay. Means this string is end with this string. Okay. So output will be true. But in start with function, this functions return a boolean type value true if a given string is used to add the prefix to the another string. Prefix means start with. So in this example, computer is fun and string b is equal to your. So p dot start with b. So it will return x as a false because string p does not start with your. Okay, start with computer, not your. So it will return x as a false value. Okay. So I hope you understand what is the string functions and how it work. Okay. So thanks for watching this video. Thank you.